Citizens of Pakistan, it is with feelings of greatest happiness and emotion that I send you my greeting. August the 15th is the birthday of the independent and sovereign state of Pakistan. It marks the fulfillment of the destiny of the Muslim nation, which has made great sacrifices in the past few years to have its homeland. At this supreme moment, my thoughts are with those valiant fighters in our corps who readily sacrificed all they had including their lives to make Pakistan possible. Let me assure them that Pakistan would remain grateful to them and cherish the memory of those who are no more. The creation of the new state has placed a tremendous responsibility on the citizens of Pakistan. It gives them an opportunity to demonstrate to the world how a nation containing many elements can live in peace and amity and work for the betterment of all its citizens irrespective of caste or creed. Our object should be peace within and peace without. We want to live peacefully and maintain cordial, friendly relations with our immediate neighbors and with the world at large. We have no aggressive design against anybody. We stand by the United Nations Charter and will gladly make our full contribution to peace and prosperity of the world. Muslims in India have shown to the world that they are a united nation and their cause is just and righteous, which cannot be denied. Let us on this day humbly thank God for his bounty and pray that we might be able to prove that we are worthy of it. This day marks the end of a poignant phase in our national history, and it should also be the beginning of a new and a noble era. Let us impress the minorities by our word, deed and thought that as long as they fulfill their duties and obligations as loyal citizens of Pakistan, they have nothing to fear. To the states beyond our borders, we send our greetings and assure them that Pakistan will extend to them its most friendly cooperation in preserving peace. We have no ambition beyond the desire to live honorably and let others live honorably. Today is the Jumat al-Wida, the last Friday of the holy month of Ramadan, and to the day of rejoicing for all of us, wherever they may be, in this subcontinent, and for the matter of that, throughout the world. Let the Muslim congregation, in their thousands, in all the mosques, bow in all humility before the Almighty, thank him for his eternal kindness and generosity, seeking his assistance and guidance in the task of making Pakistan into a great state and themselves into its worthy citizens. Finally, let me tell you, fellow citizens, that Pakistan is a land of great potential resources, but to build it up into a country worthy of the Muslim nation, which will require every ounce of energy that we possess. And I'm confident that it will come from all wholeheartedly. Pakistan, Zindabad.
This was Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah's address to the nation on 15th August 1947.